Leeds United have some pretty big losses in their lineup right now, and at this point in the season, that can be a very, very serious issue. There are only 7 games to go, and you need as many options as possible just so you've got that nice, varied toolkit for any given match to make sure you find a way to get all of the points that are available for you. But what are the threats? What are the problems? Why are they problems? And ultimately, how can Leeds United build out of this and still find themselves in the promotion places? I'm going to go through that in this video. But first, important to note, this isn't a match preview for the Hull City match. That's going to come out tomorrow. So subscribe to make sure that it gets recommended to you, because I think that's going to be a pretty good one and a very good match against Hull. But we need to talk about Leeds United's injury issues, and they're a little bit vast. There are more of them than we hoped we'd have at this point in time. There are more of them than even Daniel Farke implied in his first press conference when we came back from the international break, which isn't good, and it means that the team is potentially structurally struggling as a result of it. And I think there is one domino that set off that little collapse, that little big fall over that we're having to deal with at the moment. And the main domino, in my opinion, is Ilya Gruev, who was an absolute diamond of a signing. We need to remember that we signed Ilya Gruev for something like £4 or £5 million, something really small like that. And the fact of the matter is, he can hold down the middle of the park so effectively in a way that other holding midfielders don't. Because he's not just someone that will try and position himself where the attacker is going, and if the attacker goes there, challenge them. Which you see with some defensive midfielders. No, he is someone that will doggedly chase every single ball and make sure that he is at least in the conversation to win it. Which is something that you need in the Championship above anything else, because that level of energy can set you apart from the rest of the players in this division. Because although the Championship is a good division, it's one where not everyone has that edge. Everyone has a little bit of a flaw to them. And for a lot of players, that's the energy. And Ilya Gruev has that in spades. And in my opinion, it's very telling that Daniel Farke considered his position as the most worthy of an instant fix. He was happy to sacrifice the centre-back positions in the match against Watford in order to make sure that there was someone similar to Gruev in midfield. And in theory, that was going to be Ampadu, but Ampadu still wasn't quite the right profile for that. So we changed things around again, dropped Ampadu to centre-back, Gray's a little bit more energy pushed into midfield, and that helped again. And the issue is, without Ilya Gruev, Watford sliced through us. Our midfield was borderline non-existent. And he is still a doubt for the Hull City match, and is someone that we could quite desperately do with having back in the team. If he is fit, I say start him. I know that I keep saying you don't want to start those players that are in doubt, but Hull are a dangerous side. They're on bad form at the moment, without a doubt, but you still want to play Gruev if you can. Another player that would be a very nice option to have at this stage in the season, because they offer something a little bit different to all the others in their position, is Conor Roberts. Now, Conor Roberts isn't necessarily a starter. That's fine. Archie Gray has effectively kept him out of the side because Gray is really good and is... I've just realised all season I've been calling him a literal child, but he's not anymore, is he? He's barely an adult, and he's still one of the best right-backs in the league. But he does provide a more direct alternative to Archie Gray, the way that Conor Roberts is more happy to just bomb on, hit the byline, cut a ball back, and he visibly has an impact on the game. You only need to look at the Leicester match as an example of that. Conor Roberts came on, Archie Gray shuffled over to left-back, and Conor Roberts, within a few minutes, managed to score himself a goal and get Leeds United back into that game. And it's that ability to just sort of make an instant impact that is colossal in this division, especially when there's 7 games left and every single moment starts to count a little bit more than it did 4 or 5 months ago. There are going to be some grindy, grindy games coming up, and he would be absolutely perfect for them. And the fact that we don't have him is a little bit not good. He's injured for 3 weeks, according to Daniel Farke, and potentially back for the Middlesbrough match. If things go well and it's closer to 2 weeks, then likely to be back for Blackburn. But the sooner we can get him back, the more options we've got and the more we can shuffle things around. That would be incredibly beneficial. Because not only that, but Conor Roberts being fit means that you also free up Archie Gray to take up another midfield slot. Because with Gruev out and Ampadu playing at centre-back and Archie Gray playing at right-back, you need to sacrifice one of those positions. If Conor Roberts is fit, you don't need to do that anymore. But either way, we do have another slight injury worry, and that is Jorginho Rutter. Now, Rutter is, in theory, fit. He did start against Watford, came off roughly an hour or so in, I think. But at his best, he absolutely destroys the Championship. Issue is, recently he's not quite been at his best because he's been playing with a little bit of an injury niggle, a little bit of a hernia problem that was surgically repaired during the international break. The recovery time was something like 10 days, which he was comfortably with him. Issue is, he clearly struggled against Watford. He was, A, not have the energy that you'd be used to him having. He wasn't quite as confident with his take-ons. He wasn't quite as successful with his take-ons and didn't create as many opportunities as we'd want to see. And the issue with that is there isn't a clear replacement for him. The only other number 10 that we have in the side at the moment... Can you guys hear that ice cream, man? The only other number 10 we have in the side at the moment is Joel Pirou. But Joel Pirou is never really convincing when he plays as a number 10, to the point that, in my opinion, Matteo Joseph has hopped up the pecking order to sort of replace him, because I think he's just played better recently and made a little bit more of a sort of statement for himself. And the fact there isn't that clear replacement for Jorginho Rutter is A, something that will be fixed in the summer, I'm sure, but B, a reason that we really need him fit for the rest of this season. We do have another attacking issue as well. Oh, the fun never stops. It's Willy Nonto. He got himself a knock during the international break with Italy, not the senior team. They're under 21s, but I remember the Italy manager saying that he would have been playing for the senior side if the under 21s didn't need to qualify for the Euros. He's set to miss something like 3 weeks, the same sort of time frame as Conor Roberts, which means Borough, if it is the 3 weeks, if it's down to two, Blackburn, which, not the worst of time frames. Annoyingly, though, he'd really hit his stride in recent weeks. He'd been scoring goals for fun, away from home especially, but he finally got that home breakthrough versus Millwall, fired the ball in to the side netting, and to be honest, the way that the crowd erupted told me that he'd finally been accepted by everyone. But the fact of the matter is, if he's not fit, that acceptance doesn't really mean much, because he can't turn it into an impact on the pitch. And with Willy Nonto not being available right now, it's definitely time for Dan James to step up, which hopefully he'll be able to do. If he's not, things could get a little bit spooky. We might be relying a little bit too much on Crescencio Somerville. Jadon Anthony playing out on the right isn't quite where he's comfortable either. Basically, we've got one right wing player that is a little low on confidence, being Dan James after the Wales thing, and one who is injured. So that's good. Anyway, what is the ideal lineup for Leeds United right now? Let me know in the comments down below, and I'll tell you mine in my match preview tomorrow, because it's going to vary from game to game. Hull will need different responses to a Middlesbrough, to a Blackburn, to a Southampton, and we need to make sure that we are getting those right responses in place to make sure that we get as many points as we can. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please drop a like down here, comment, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I will see you later. I really don't know if you can hear the ice cream van, but if you can, I'm getting an ice cream.